The topic project feasibility. Now, what is project feasibility? We see in the definition of the project feasibility. Okay. After that one, we see the detail about how to write a project feasibility report. In that one, we have learned about the raw material survey. In the project feasibility report, we have to include a raw material survey. In detail, we seen the raw material survey. The demand study is another point that we need to put it into the project feasibility report by writing the project feasibility report. After that one, we learn about the technical feasibility. So the technical things related to the project. So that part that we are covered in the last lecture. And now we will look about the location study. Now in the project feasibility report, we have to include this point, a location. Now this location is very important. If you choose a proper location for your project, then there is no chance of failure. Otherwise, if you choose a wrong place, in that case, it's very difficult for us to run that project. So let's see what are the things that we have to include while studying the location one, okay, in the projects. So the properly select the project site is an important task. And for that one, what are the considerations that we have to do here? It is. Availability of land and cost of land. Now this is the one of the important part that we have to just consider during the location study, that where is the availability of land for your project. Does the land is available? Does the society or the government or the other department are ready to give you give the land for that project? Because many times, either it is a government project or some private project, they are failure just because they are not getting a land. For example, many times we have the disputes in the Jaitapur and Nanar project. So we are not unable to even start that project just because of the availability of land. They are opposing the people for giving the land for that project. Or even you can have one example that is in the Pachim Bang, in the West Bengal. Okay, so when the project of nano car, it is shifted from that the West Bengal to the Gujarat just because of the unavailability of land. So here it is very important for you to do a study on it. And what is the cost of the land? This is again one important point that we need to study about the costing of land. If you are comparing the cost of land in Mumbai and the cost of land in the local region, then you see there is a more costing. And for that one, again, we need to check it the availability of land in Mumbai and what is the cost of it. Because on that one, your project costing is depend. And that is very important. Though the location is very good, you have the market, you have the raw material, but unfortunately, the costing of land is very high. Because of that one, your cost of the project is growing multiple times what if you comparing with the local site. Okay, so here we always look out that part. And if it is okay that the project which you have considered in Mumbai and you can pay that the cost of that land, then there is no problem for you. Okay, so but yes, it is need to learn and you have to include that local location study in the project feasibility report. Raw material and transportation facility. Now again the question arises, does that site which we are chosen, are the raw material is available? What is the transportation facility? Okay, first things, the raw material. For example, if we have to start the mango processing plant in Mumbai, then obviously we know that the maximum mango are grown in the Konkan region in Ratnagiri and Sindhudurga site. And if we are placing or establishing a plant in the Mumbai, then the raw material transportation is the one of the problem we have. Okay, so it may have, you have to long way, you have to take the raw material from one place to the another place. So costing of the raw material transportation is increased. Similarly, look at the transportation facility. Now if the location where you are choose the project, Does the transportation facilities available means sometimes what happened because of the low costing of the land, we are going to from the metro cities to the rural area. And in that rural area, again, we are stuck up just because we don't have the facility for the transportation. We are only depend on the roadways, and that roadways is also not in a good condition. So it's again difficult for us to collect the raw material for the process, and again, whatever the finished product that you are producing need to reach to the customer, and that is obviously it is by the transportation, and you may have the delay just because of the transportation. So here you always check the transportation facility near to your project. I'm not saying there is a zero distance, but yes, it is nearer to you. So what are the transportation facilities? You have to check the railways. Okay, rail ways one thing, second is the roadways, and is it possible fire by the boat and by the ship, can we transport that one? Okay, so check the transportation facility nearer to your project so that it is easy for taking the raw material and just giving transporting the finished product to the market of finished product. Another things that we need to check in the location study, it is a market of finished product. The product which you are manufacturing in that area, does the market is available for the finished product? If it is not, then it is not a good idea to establish that plant in that area. For example, that if the demand of the finished product is in Mumbai, and you are producing the product in somewhere in Ratnagiri, okay, as we are located in Ratnagiri, so we say in Ratnagiri, so there will be maybe the 400 500 distance, and we need to transport that all the finished product to that market. But if it is nearer to that one, then what happened, your costing on the transportation can be cut off, you can reduce that cost, and that can be happen if the market is available nearer to you, the raw material is nearer to you, so there is no need to go away from it. Okay, because this is the operating cost. Though the costing of land to purchase, if it is a high, then no problem because it is a fixed cost. But this is what we call the operating cost, and for that one, we need to check it the market of finished product, source and availability of the water. Now, if you consider the process, the chemical engineering plant, okay. In that one, there is a processes are carried out, and for the processes, we need the water as a main utility. Okay, now does the water is available in the project site? Okay, if the answer is yes, how much it is available? Because the project which you are establishing or which you want to start in that area, first you have to check whether the project is need a water or not. If they need water, what is the quantity of the water that you need? How many days the water that you need? And on that basis, does that water is available in that proportion with planning of the future? If the answer is yes, then we can choose that location. Availability of the power, this is also the main constraint, because many times when you are choosing the rural area, in that case, you know that what happened to the power cut. So here, what power is available, does the electricity is available, there is a gas pipeline is available. Okay, you need energy to run a plant, and for that energy, for the running that plant, we need a power, we need the energy. And what is the sources of energy? Is it available easily? If it is available easily, then we can run the project very well, we run the plant very well. Otherwise, many times if we are dependent, then it is very difficult for us to run. Just like electricity, we need 24 hours. Now in the rural area, you might be get the electricity for the 12 hours. So that is not the choice, right choice of the location. Okay, but yes, you need to check that part too while selection of the location. Availability, skill, manpower around the site. This is again one important point, because the persons, there are the many manpowers required for the running the plant. So does the skill manpowers is available around your site? And what is the benefit? One benefit is that if the manpower is available nearer to your site, if it is a localite, then if you want to the wages, you might be have the reduce the wages of that person, and person also doesn't have any problem because he is nearer to the plant and their location is also nearer to the plant, and because of that one there is a win-win situation between the person who is the employer and the person who is the employee. So you can reducing the cost of the product. But if the location is somehow away from your city, of your location of that employee, then definitely he want more wages because of the extra expenditure on it. So that is the one case. And the skill manpower is again very important, because many times you are not getting a skill manpower and ultimately your project gets failed. Okay, so easily availability of the skill manpower around your site is again the one of the factor to check in the location study. The another point is availability of the tax incentives. It is availability of tax incentives. Now, what is meant by tax incentives? As I given an example of the Mumbai metro city. Now, the taxes of in Mumbai MIDC and the taxes of in Ratnagiri MIDC, it might be the different one. Just because the government gives some incentives, okay, just to start a plant to the rural area, so that there will be get some what we call the jobs to the people of the rural area, and for that one they give some benefit to the employer, they give the benefit to the organization, okay, those who want to start the business or the project in the rural area. So you again need to check the tax incentives. If you get a more tax incentives in the rural area, and if there is no matter whether the site is away from the raw material or the site is away from the finished market product, still you can choose that one, just because the incentives that you get in taxes, and that might be the more, and you calculate that part. If you see that is beneficial for us, then we will go for that, choosing that particular site. Then the facilities for the effluent disposal. Now this is very important when you are choosing the chemical plant. Facilities for the effluent disposal means the waste which is generated from your plant, does there is a availability or there is have a facility to disposal of that waste. Otherwise the extra expenditure on we have required for the effluent disposal. Just like I would like to give one example again related to the from the Ratnagiri, it is what we have a plant of the octal, we have the plant of the phenolex. Okay, this is a big industries, and yes, as it is not a chemical zone declared, so what happened, the MIDC doesn't give a facility for the disposal of their waste. So these industries, they themselves have to pay and just have the spend money for the effluent disposal. Ultimately, the costing of effluent disposal is high. But if you are comparing with the Lote MIDC, in that one, there is a common ETP plant is available. So if you don't have the place to available, or if you don't have the technology, then what you do, you are paying some money and you have to send it directly to the central ATP plant, or we call the common ATP plant, and for that one what you can save that money, you can save the expenditure which you have to spend for the establishment of that effluent plant. Instead of that one, as the facility is available, you directly send it to the common effluent treatment plant. Okay, so this is very important. Again, you need to check the facility of the effluent disposal. After that one, we have to check the acceptance by the local body. And again, this is what we call very interesting one, as already we have suffered with this one. The acceptance of the local society. Why? You know that if you see the Nanar and the Jetapur projects, both are just stuck up just because the local peoples are opposing that project. Whatever be the reason may be the correct or may not be correct, whatever it is, but yes, it cannot accepted that project, the project is not accepted by the local peoples, and that's why that project is stopped. they are not able to just to establish that project and to run that project just because of the opposition by the local body. So here this point is very important to just to note down that the one it is called acceptance by the local bodies. This is the first priority that you need to check. Are that project is accepted by or accept by the people? And the lastly, the overall evaluation means after that one, there are maybe there's some plus point, there may be there's some minus point, whatever it is. And then after that one, we will give that the main conclusion from the location study exactly where you want to locate it. So you have to check out the incentives, you have to check out the effluent disposal, you have to check out the raw material availability, look at the market of the finished product, and all the points need to be considered. And from that one, you are optimizing it. And that optimum result that will give the exact location where you want to establish the plant. Now the next topic from the project feasibility report, it is to project cost estimate. Now obviously we are establishing any type of the project or we want to start a project, and it's very important to what is the cost of it, how we can estimate what is the cost of the project. Okay, and that is to be again need to be included in the project report, in the project feasibility report, because ultimately the money is the important part. What will be the cost and what will be the benefit? So here some approximately cost that we need to check out before we started the project. Just like if you want to buy a mobile, then always you search in a market which is the latest mobile is available, what is the cost of the mobile and the other functions too, and does is it possible for me that I can buy that mobile? Because again the money is the important part. If we have the money available with us, then we can buy that mobile of 20,000, 30,000, whatever it is. But if you don't have, then again it's very difficult. So budgeting is very important. So here also we need to check what will be the cost of the project, and that is to be approximately that we need to calculate. So in that one, what are the points to be covered in the project estimate? First, that we can divide the capital cost, which is we call it is a fixed cost, and the another is the working cost, which we call it is operating cost. So both the cost is very important. Just like when you are buying any mobile phones or when you are buying any bike, so that time you always check what is the fixed cost initially you are spending on it, on that product, on that object, and what will be the operating cost. Just like if you want to buy the motorcycle, okay, in that case you always check what is the fixed cost. Let's say it is 80,000 is a fixed cost, is no problem for me, I can spend that money 80,000. Then again you check what is the operating cost, mean the maintenance cost of that bike. So when you see the maintenance cost of bike, you see the consumption, petrol consumption of the oil and the other maintenance parts, services and all. So if you see that the operating cost is very high, then that time we have to skip that idea and we will go for the another product which will have a less operating cost. Okay, you know that in a market there are the number of bikes are available, and you know what that the maintenance and the operating cost is very high comparing to the fixed cost. You can spend the money on the fixed cost, but it is very difficult for maintaining the bike. Just because of the operating and working one. If any bike, if you give only the 20 and 30 kilometer per hour per liter is the average, and another bike might be given the 60 kilometer per liter. So definitely the operating cost of the first one is very high, and now we need to check that part too. So here we are looking for it, capital cost and the working cost. So what are the terms including the capital cost? And before that, we will see what is mean by capital cost. So this is we say that all the costs incurred in the project before it becomes ready to start a commercial production. Means we have to include all that cost. we have to include all the costs before commercial production start. Okay, it means the cost of the land, cost of the building, cost of the machineries, cost for the erection. Okay, each and everything just before to start the plant, start the process. That will be the capital cost. It may be the wages during when the erection of the plant. It may be the raw material which is required for the erection of the plant. The technology which you are buying, that will be the cost. So everything that is included here. So here is the expenditure on the land, machineries, townships, license, designing, engineering, softwares, whatever be the things that is included in it, that will be the capital cost. It means once I started the plant, then the raw material and the finished product and other things that will be covered up in the working one. But here, the main expenditure is on land, on the machineries, on the technology that you are buying, means the license fees and all. Okay, so that is very important in the that is to be included in the capital cost, or we call it the fixed cost. Means this is a depreciation one. Okay, so if you look at the land, if you look at the machinery especially, this is the what a fixed cost, but it is a depreciation. So there is continuously depreciating the cost. Means if you buy a machinery of say 5 lakh rupees, after a 10 years, that 5 lakhs to be 1 lakh. And again, you need to check what will be the life cycle of that equipment. How many years it will give the service to you. Okay, but yes, but here you need to hear the one point that you have to cover. It is to capital cost is what that cost which is required before to start a commercial production. Now the operating cost, or we call it is a working cost. Now what is that working cost? Apart from the fixed one, whatever be the remaining, that will be the operating cost. Now what is your operating cost? Which will be incurred on recurring basis of production, maintenance and marketing. Means the cost which you are include in the production one, production, maintenance, marketing, and again the wages of the employees, services, all these things are included in the operating. Means the monthly you have to pay. It may have a raw material that is also considered under the operating cost, because for running that plant you need to buy a raw material. Okay, you have to spend on the production, means on the process, the maintenance of the plant, you have to pay the money or spend the money on it. The marketing is the important part of it, the wages of the people. Okay, that is important. The services that you are giving, all this comes under the operating one. The labor payment, okay, raw materials, utilities, repair and maintenance, selling expenses. So as we said, these are raw material, labor, utilities. Utilities means it may have the steam that you use, the electricity, the power, energy, the gases that you can use, okay, the water, all this comes under the utilities, and you have to pay a bill monthly to that. Okay, then the repair and maintenance cost and selling expenses. You can take one example of your home. If you want to start the construction of your home, so the purchasing of the land and the construction of that house or home. Okay, so that will be the fixed cost. Initially, everything you have to just given to that one, and that will be the fixed one. Now, what is the maintenance cost? Maintenance cost, it may be the water that you are using, the electricity that you are using. Many times you need a maintenance, because after a 2 3 years you require to paint the home. You may have the ch changes the switches or other the parts. That is the maintenance one of that home. Okay, so this is the important this is the one of the example that where we can say it is the operating cost. Same is here in the industry. Raw materials, amount spent, labor payment, utilities, repair and maintenance, and the selling expenses, means the marketing one. All this comes under the operating cost. And the addition of these two will give a total project cost. And in the during the estimation, what we do for the 3 months, we have to take our operating cost in it as a total project cost, because when you want to run that business, that time we have to include initially the months, so that that will give the total cost of the project. Now, what are the sources? As I say, we can calculate the what is the operating cost. We can calculate what is the project, the capital cost, and we get a total cost of the project. Now, the money which is available to the any company or industry is not all the money is available to them. They are not spending all the amount which is required for the project. Okay. For that one, they need a finance. So what are the sources of the finance? Again, as a project manager, we should know which are the sources of the finance. So where from I get the money? Where from I get to money to purchasing all these things and to erection of this plant? So here we can have to know at least the certain points related to the finance. It will have the terms of finance, short-term financing, intermediate financing, long-term finance. Terms of finance means what? Whether you need the finance for a short term, for an intermediate, and for the long. We will see the definition of it, what exactly meaning of short term. Short term means just like you want to purchase a raw material. If you want to purchase a raw material, that time you need money for 2 to 3 months only. So that is what we call it is a short term finance. Okay. So in details, we will see about it. What is meant by short term finance? So first is, it refers the short-term finance. It refers to business or the personal loans that have the shorter than average time span for repaying the loan, typically 1 year or less. It means if you want to purchase a raw material, because in market you can get the raw material in a cheapest price. So because of that one, what we do, we want to store that raw material, because next 6 months we need to use that raw material for making a finished product. So what we do, we don't have that much money available in our balance sheet. So what we do, we take a short term loan less than 1 year, means you have to repay that amount within a 1 year. So what we do, initial month, we are purchasing the raw material and we take the finance from the bank or the other sectors, and we are repay that one after 6 months, after 8 months, but yes, it is before the 1 year. So that loan we call it is the short term financing. The another is the intermediate terms finance. What is the intermediate terms? So this is relating to an investment with the expected holding period somewhere between the short term and long term, that we call intermediate. That's why the name is intermediate. It means the period is 1 to 3 years. For the short term finance, we have to repay the amount before the 1 year, and in the intermediate one, we have to repay it between the 1 to 3 years. Okay, between the 1 to 3 years. For example, buying of the equipment having a life of 1 to 3 years, just like the financial institute, they know that what is the life cycle of that equipment, what is the lifespan of that equipment, and accordingly they are giving a loan to you. Even when you are visiting to any bank or the financial institute, they always check what is the depreciation of that particular object. It may be the equipment, it may be the home, anything it is. So they always take see the what is the depreciation, and before the depreciation they have want to recover that the money. Just like if your equipment which having the life of 7 years, so if that equipment which having the life of 7 years, in that case what happened, the financial institute, they are giving a loan and they want to repay the loan before the 3 to 4 years, because he know that after the 7 years there is no use of that equipment. And certainly, if the person is not able to give the return the money, then it is not possible for them to sell that equipment. And that's why they always keep that year as low as possible. Okay. The long-term finance is especially from the 3 to 10 years. It might be fluctuate nowadays. Definitely, we will not stuck up with these particular values. Okay. Whether it is the what we call the okay, it might be say this is 3 and 1 to 3. Okay, so long term is what? Long term means we can pay the or return the money to the financial institute within a 3 to 10 years. Just like when you are purchasing a home loan, then it is a long term loan. But when you are purchasing somehow the bike or the any vehicle, then it is a very short term loan. We call it is intermediate, not short term, but we call it is intermediate. Okay, just because it is depend on the what is the depreciation of that particular the things that we have purchased. And here for the long term finance, definitely for the long term we always consider. Whether you want to construct the building for getting the loan, the money for the purchasing the equipments, purchasing the technology. So we say that the cost which is required, we call it is a capital cost. Okay, for the capital cost, it is always we have to buy a long-term finance. So long-term finance is what generally asset and new projects. It is used to purchase the equipment, machinery, building construction, as I said. So which are the financial institute here? One is the National Institute, Foreign Institute. You may get a loan from the nationalized, you may get a loan from the financial. So let's see in a quickly what is the financial institute in the national one, who is providing the loan to you? The one is the Industrial Development Bank of India. So it is the IDBI Bank. And nowadays all the banks are, whether it is a State Bank of India, whether it is a Bank of India, or whether it is the HDFC, ICICI, private banks, all these are providing the loans to the projects. Before a few years ago, only certain the financial institute they are providing. One of them, it is Industrial Finance Corporation of India, Life Insurance Corporation. So these are the certain financial institute from our India which are providing the loan or giving the finance to the project. Apart from this, we can purchase the loan or we have the financial aids with the foreign financial institutes too. So which are that financial institute? World Bank. You know the you maybe heard the word World Bank. Okay, so this is one of the financial institute. Any country can buy get a loan from the World Bank. Okay, another is the International Monetary Fund, IMF. So this is also one of the institute which are providing the loan. So this two, if you call this two, this is from the international one, okay, World Bank and the International Monetary Fund. So this is purely they give the fund to the government. They are not giving the fund to the private sector. They are giving the loan. The World Bank, it always give the loan to the foreign, to the country. Just like if you want some programs and especially for the society, okay, for the development. So they are providing the loan to us. The next topic from this cost estimation is the preparation of the cost estimates. Okay, but yes, that we will see in the next class about the what is the cost estimate in the given economic viability of the project. We need to check the feasibility of the report, the project. For that one, we have to check that there is given the types of estimate. What are the various types of the estimates? Okay, which can divide it 5 to 6 parts, which is the order of magnitude, study estimate, preliminary estimate, definitive estimate, and the detailed estimate. But all these things, there is a point that we will see in the next class.